Hi friends, today let us see the recent decision by FSSAI to color code all the food products in India. So it is in news that the Food Safety and Standards Authority of India, shortly called as FSSAI, issued draft guidelines. These are not final, but draft guidelines on labeling tagged food products. Okay, so the FSSAI is planning to implement traffic light labeling. Traffic light labeling is nothing but where different color codes are used, like orange, red, orange, and green. So like that, the color codes are used for the food products. So why is it important to label food products? It works as a link between a consumer and the manufacturer, and also it will be easy for the customer to choose which product is good for health and which is not. So what is this traffic light labeling actually? So the traffic light labeling uses three different colors: red, yellow or orange, and green. So we know that in different products, different levels of fat, different levels of sugar, and different levels of salt is included. So if you buy any product from the market, so if it contains 7.7 grams of fat, so and this is a permissible limit of fat, then that particular code will be in green color. So for example, here you can see that this fat is in green color. So like that, each serving is mentioned on the food product, and how much of sugar, how much of salt, how much of saturated fat, how much of unsaturated fat is present, everything is mentioned. And if these levels are within the permissible limit, then it is in green color. If it is very high, then it is in red color. For example, here you can see sugar level is very high, so 38% sugar, so it is given in red color. And salt is 15%, it is not very high, it is not very low, so it is medium, so it is given in orange or yellow color. So this will help the customer to choose which product is good. Also, it will educate the customer on what the product actually contains. For example, many children, they do not know what is in the chocolates and all. So this will be a way to educate the children also. Children can easily come to know that how much of sugar is present in that food and etc. Okay, so apart from this color labeling, there are many other proposed provisions that FSSAI is actually going to implement. So let us discuss these different provisions in the draft. First point is nutritional information to be displayed in calories, trans fat, saturated fat, etc. As we already discussed, each and every food product contains different levels of calories, different trans fat, different saturated fat, etc. So everything should be mentioned on the food package. So that is what is the first provision. And the second provision is color coding to be displayed on the front of the packing. So we have discussed this, the red, orange or yellow and green color coding. And then the manufacturing date and expiry date to be displayed at one place. This is very important because on many of the food products available in India, we already know that the manufacturing date is mentioned at one corner and the expiry date is mentioned somewhere at the bottom or at the top of the cap. So the third provision is that manufacturing and expiry date should be mentioned at one place. Also, allergies are to be mentioned on the food package because some people have allergy to peanuts, some people have allergy to different food products. So all the allergies should be mentioned on the food packing itself. And any material that is not meant for human consumption should be displayed in this symbol. So this symbol here, okay, X symbol. So any food product that is not meant for consumption, it should be displayed in X color. Also, the mandatory labeling requirement of veg and non-veg. For veg, green color, and for non-veg, red color. So mandatorily, all the food products should have these marks. If it's veg, it should be in green. If it's non-veg, it should be in red color. So we have discussed these provisions, but what actually is FSSAI? Who is FSSAI to implement these all these rules? FSSAI, the full form of FSSAI is Food Safety and Standards Authority of India. It was established under Food Safety and Standards Act 2006. It comes under Ministry of Health and Family, and the main aim is to lay down scientific standards for food items and regulate their manufacture, storage, distribution and sale. And they are the ones who are responsible to make sure that the public consume healthy food, or at least only healthy or standard, scientifically standard products are available in the market. So FSSAI is also responsible for advising the government in framing policies. For example, here in this case, the color coding policy, it is FSSAI who is advising the government. Not only the central government, but also the state governments. FSSAI can advise both central and state governments. So, okay, we now know that FSSAI is implementing these rules and all. But where did FSSAI get these rules from? So there is one more international organization called Codex Alimentarius. So this Codex Alimentarius is an international organization. So what does it do? It has the collection of internationally recognized standards, codes of practice, guidelines, and other recommendations relating to food, food production, and food safety. It was established in 1961 by Food and Agricultural Organization, FAO. And this organization runs under the United Nations. So United Nations looks after this Food and Agriculture Organization. So it was this organization that actually recommended the color coding of food products. Not only Codex Alimentarius, there are different organizations which actually is encouraging countries to code their food products. Already many countries are implementing this, and now FSSAI has agreed to implement this. So this is all about the FSSAI regulation. If you like the video, please do subscribe to the channel, and please do like us on Facebook, and please do like the video also. You can also follow us on Twitter. All the links are below. Thank you.